of Harley-Davidson, I'd like to thank all y'all for watching. My name is Astronautilus, and I'm gonna be your host for this historic occasion. We're coming to you from Milan, Italy, home of the EICMA International Motorcycle Exhibition, the biggest motorcycle show in the world. And for the first time in its 110-year history, Harley's participating in EICMA to reveal not one, but two brand new motorcycles. These dark custom bikes are built for a whole new generation of global riders. They'll give you that personal freedom, but with the attitude, with the edge, the soul of today's modern cities. But with that look, that sound, that feel, that lets everybody know they are genuine Harley-Davidsons. But enough talk, y'all. Let's check these bad boys out.
Welcome to Milan. Thanks for coming. Before we talk about the news we have to share with you tonight, I want to talk a little bit about what's brought us here today and the path of Harley-Davidson as it's gone through 110 years. Because we've crossed many generations in those 110 years. In fact, our whole company was started by four young adults in a garage in 1903, the ultimate garage startup. Some even call Harley-Davidson the original social network. And because of that, we recognize these people and we connect to them like they do to all the generations of passionate young adults that came before them, even while they're their own unique breed. So what at Harley-Davidson could we create for them? Well, what if we could evoke the old school cool of the XLCR, like the bike along the wall in the back, Harley-Davidson's original cafe racer? How about we add a trick or two from our liquid-cooled V-Rod and brought the cultural attitude of dark custom to young adults all over the world? What if we brought the power of Harley-Davidson to new streets, urban streets, the streets where this generation lives? And now, what if we gave birth to the first all-new platform from Harley-Davidson in 13 years? We are proud to reveal to you, for the first time anywhere in the world, the Street 750 and Street 500 from Harley-Davidson.
Trust me, in person, these bikes look even more amazing. Earlier today, Senior Manager of Styling for Harley-Davidson, Frank Savage, gave me a guided tour. Man, this is not my street vibe. Tell me about it.
Yeah, so your street bob basically has a horizontal stance to it, right?
Yeah.
With the street, we changed that and we kicked it down. We gave it an aggressive cut. So the cut starts with the rear fender and drives all the way through the vehicle.
Yeah.
It's aggressive pavement-eating attitude.
And this is built for the city. Tell me what went into the design to make it a city bike.
Well, as you know, the heart and soul of any Harley-Davidson is the powertrain. The Revolution X is a 60-degree liquid-cooled V-twin.
It's crazy, tuned
to handle any extreme cities across the globe.
I gotta sit on it, you gotta sit on it?
Yeah, check it out. The first thing you're gonna notice is your feet are planted.
Mm-hmm.
That's because of the low seat height. No matter your size, your feet will be on the ground at every stoplight. Put your hands up on the bars now. Notice that wide grip,
yeah.
Narrow front end. It's tuned for maximum maneuverability and agility. You're gonna be able to boogie through the streets and get around cars like nobody's business.
This is fantastic. The suspension's really nice too.
So the suspension is tuned for potholes and bumps. It's gonna bring you over that stuff comfortably.
That's awesome. I live in Minnesota. After the winter, man, it's like swimming pools.
There you go.
So you've got liquid cooled, you got the suspension, you got all of this new that's going into it. Tell me a little bit about the history of Harley and the heritage that you pulled into this design.
Right on. So we have the new teardrop tank, and it's basically a mashup of our 1946 knucklehead.
Yeah.
Nice teardrop. Combined with the 1948 peanut, you can see how the edge has been kind of aggressively cut like the peanut. It's a beautiful combination of the two.
It's great.
All new teardrop for the street.
Tell me about those rims. Those rims are tight.
Yeah, so we have 7-spoke cast rims, highlighted edge. Beautiful.
Nothing is more classic than this thing. Tell me about that
totally
speed screen.
Right. So what we look at is visual DNA. What do we draw from it? Designers are looking through our archives, checking things out. This is direct imagery from 1980s FXR. The guys in California are blasting down the street.
That's classic.
This is pure fist in the wind attitude.
Amazing. Mark Hans.
Hey.
Thanks for taking some time out of your day.
Yeah, thanks. Thanks for having
me. You've been busy, man. You had the 110th anniversary.
Yeah.
Project Rushmore.
Yeah.
You had the Pope.
Yeah. Where are you?
He didn't answer your text?
He didn't, no. It's been a great year. It's been amazing. So, you know, we launched a whole new platform, our biggest launch in 110 years with Project Rushmore. It's 110th anniversary all over the world. Customers having a great time. We're happy to have a great time with them. I'm going to be sorry to see the year go, but it's really just setting up the future too, so that's pretty cool.
That's exciting. Why come to Milan for this launch? Why now?
Well, you know, Milan's the center of the International Motorcycle Show, EICMA. And it's really where most of motorcycle companies put their best foot forward. And for us, this is our best foot forward. We have these great Project Rushmore bikes that we just introduced to the world a few months ago, and this whole new platform, the Street 750 and 500. So it really shows a lot of dimensions of what Harley-Davidson can do, and shows the world what we're going to be up to in the next couple of years.
Tell me, Mark Hans, tell me about the sound and feel of these new bikes.
That's a great question. You know, the Street 750, Street 500, they're really built with a different use in mind. It's literally for streets. And so, you know, urban environments, you got to be nimble, you got to be agile, you got a lot of stop and go, and we got to address all that and serve our customers well. And we listen to our customers, 1,600 different one-on-one interviews with people all around the world to find out what they were looking for from Harley. It's nimble, it's lean, but it's still made out of steel. Even with the steel, it's still less than 500 pounds, only 480 pounds, dripping wet, full of gas, full of oil, anything you got. It's liquid-cooled V-twin engine for stop and go, lots of heat going on, lots, you know, you need a liquid-cooled engine. But yet it still sounds like an air-cooled V-twin and all the spirit of a Harley-Davidson. So it's nimble, it's lean, it's agile, it's steel, it's liquid-cooled to manage the environment that you're riding in, and that's really why it's called the Street.
That's awesome. It's an urban bike. Why make an urban Harley now, though? What's the thinking behind a global bike?
You know, just look what's going on in the world, and more people moving into city centers and living an urban lifestyle, and yet still reflecting the ethos of Harley-Davidson, you know, the spirit of it, creativity, passion, customization, tats all over your body. I mean, this is us, and it's living and breathing in urban environments all over the world, especially with this next generation of young adults that are coming up in the world, and that's, you know, something that we need to be a part of, because their spirit is our spirit, and we wanted to be part of that with them.
This is a smaller CC bike. What's the thinking behind making a smaller CC Harley?
Well, you know, it's not so much about a smaller CC as it is having a Harley that's better for what those customers want in that environment. So it might have a smaller engine, but it's all the look, sound, and feel that you'd expect from a Harley while giving them all the extra benefits they're looking for in a more challenging urban environment, so they can have the capabilities they need, but also all the style and the spirit and attitude that they expect from us.
Excellent, that's exciting. I mean,
it is exciting.
This is tough to top, but what's next for Harley? What else you got going on?
I can't tell you. Did you think I was going to tell you?
Well, this was worth a try.
Tell him anything about what's next for Harley.
Yeah, we're in Italy. No, you might have just liked
it. All I can tell you is it's going to be really exciting. And while you expect me to say that, replay this tape. It's going to be exciting.
Excellent. Thank you, Mark Hans.
Yeah, thank you.
It's been a pleasure.
All right, thanks.
Cheers. So I know what you're thinking. When can I get one? The Street 750 and 500 will be available in select markets in 2014. And of course, you can always get more information at the HD website, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and YouTube. To celebrate the release of the Street, Harley took inspiration from its fans and riders all over the world and the cities that they live in to inspire an amazing graffiti mural right here in Milan. We're going to leave you with one more taste of the Street, but I want to thank all y'all for tuning in.
Choo-choo eyeball, he was holy.